Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to do a hair tutorial for you guys. It's the look that I've been wearing recently in all of my videos. I kind of go in weird like spurts. Like sometimes I have to have my hair curly all the time. Other times I don't want to do my hair and I just wear it up in a bun for weeks on end. Right now I am in the mode of needing my hair to be curly. My hair has grown quite a bit since I last got it cut, and I think that I'm just going to keep letting it grow and see how long it gets. I forgot what I was saying. It is pretty easy to do. It's repetitive. All you're going to need is a wand. For this one, I'm just going to be using my Bellamy 6-in-1 curler. I have the 25mm barrel on this bad boy. The last hair tutorial that I did, I used the same wand, but I used the 32mm barrel, and I like to use that when I want a more kind of loose, beachy wave, and I use this when I want more glam, full-on va-va-voom hair. Now, the cool thing about this hairstyle and the products that I'm going to be using is you can keep this pretty conservative and just, you know, have a lot of texture in it and whatnot, or you can make it this big, which is usually how I like to wear my hair. I don't know why. I just love big hair. Like, my favorite kind of hair is like that like kinky curly hair, and they wear it like so natural and it's like out to here. Like, I would cut off my left arm to have that hair, but I don't, so we gotta fake it with the wand. I'm trying to drink more water. Does anybody else have a really hard time drinking water? Like, I like water, but I don't like water when I'm like eating food because I feel like I'm just drinking what I'm eating. So if like I'm like eating a burger and I take a sip of water, I feel like I'm drinking a burger. Like, is that weird? Okay, this is my 2-3 day old hair. I usually only wash my hair every 3 days or so because I do have colored hair and I don't want to wash it a lot. When I was in LA, I didn't bring my good shampoo. So as you can see, I turned a little brassy up here. Brassy is like orange. So I turned a little orange up here, so I need to get some purple shampoo to kind of combat that. But like I said, this is just my natural hair. It's not straightened or anything, it's just blow dried, so this is kind of what it looks like. Oh, I was looking for a hair tie. We're just going to quickly curl out. I see people like do their hair, like curl their hair, and they don't section it off, and I'm just like, how are you doing that? Like, I've tried to curl my hair like that, and it just doesn't work. So, what is this? What is this on my face? We're just going to give it a brush through. Ow. It's really naughty because I just woke up. And the first product that we're going to use is the Big Sexy Hair Volumizing Hairspray. I love this stuff. It is one of my favorite hairsprays. It holds my hair the best, I feel, and I can still have like movement in my hair. So, oh goodness. So I just like to take this and hold my hair up and then just spray and let it fall. Trying to spray in the opposite direction to not get the camera lens. So then it looks like this. Cute, right? We're just going to brush this out. I just wanted to spray some hairspray in my hair because I find that when I use that hairspray before I curl my hair, that my curls really, really hold. After that, we're just going to grab our wand, and I always like to start curling from the back of my head as opposed to the front because I feel like if I start curling from the front, then those front curls just get in the way of me trying to curl the back. So it's a lot easier if you start from the back of your head and work your way forward. And I like to put it behind my head and then just wrap it around. I try to keep my curl pretty flat. And by flat, hold on, let me get this. By flat, I mean I'm having it lay flat against the barrel instead of it being like twisted laying on the barrel like this. So we'll just hold that bad boy there for a second. Two chains, and we'll let it drop down. And then I just like to hold it in my hand for a second and then give it a little squeeze, kind of letting it cool there for a minute without actually pinning it. It is really hot, so if you're not used to curling your hair, it might shock you at first, but just hold it there for a second and then let it go, and then you'll have a nice little curl like this guy in the back. I'll show you again what I mean by keeping your hair flat on the barrel. So I curl it like this. And I'm not curling the hair, I'm laying it flat to the barrel, like that. And then we're just going to hold him, give him a good little squeeze, kind of getting the heat out of there so he cools more in his curl shape, as opposed to curling just hanging down. Like that. We're just going to repeat this entire process all over our head, and I'll come back when my hair is all curled and show you how to get that big texturized hair, girl. We need some music. I hate Pandora commercials.
And now, a moment of service.
Okay. Beyonce. Why won't it stop? So this is what your hair looks like after it's curled. This is just not my style whatsoever. So I have to tease it and spray it and fluff it and all kinds of crazy stuff. So I've used a ton of kind of volumizing hairsprays, and this one is the best one that I found. It's by Kendra, and it's the dry thickening spray, and it's a density building hairspray. Now it only has an index of 4 for the hold, and it goes all the way up to 26 for a maximum hold. So it's not going to give you a lot of hold in your hair, but this already is giving you hold in your hair. So this is just going to create lots of fullness, lots of texture in your hair, basically how I like to wear my hair on the regular. These have been cooling for a little minute now, and I could never see me wearing my hair like this. Like, hey guys, no, I can't do it. So I'm just going to run my fingers through and just loosen the curls up. So now I'm gonna take my dry thickening spray, and I'm gonna flip my head to one side, and I'm gonna spray this, lifting it up as I spray. Now we're getting somewhere. Then I like to go in with a wide tooth comb and just tease everything and make it more oomph. So to do this, I like to take one that's pretty wide like this, so it's not gonna catch a lot of hair in it. And what I do is just hold the bottoms of my hair, put the comb in, and then push up. What I like to do is kind of get underneath that top layer of hair, so that if this is all messy underneath, this will kind of hide it, and go ahead and push my comb up and start teasing in here. And then when I feel like it's getting a little too knotty, I'll just quickly run that comb back over it to loosen it up, that tease. But like I said, you want to hold the bottom of your hair and push up. You can do this without a comb. You can do this just by holding the ends and pushing your hair up. I just find that the comb makes it a little more neater. Is neater a word? A little more neat. That's better. And then I'll go back in with this. You can see the difference from this side to this side. Again, we're just gonna hold the ends of our hair and push up. I also like to go back in with the Big Sexy Hair, because this is a volumizing hairspray. This has a lot more hold than this does, so I do like to go back in and spray everything with this. But you want to be gentle with this hairspray, because it can leave you kind of crunchy, so just be careful with it. Spray in between, and then like hold it up, flip it. And since this side is usually a little more flat than this side, because it has less hair than this side of it does, I give this side a little more extra attention and a little extra tease, just so it kind of matches this side of my hair. Now this is my kind of hair. I don't know why I need it to be messy and big and just all in your face, but this is just how I like to wear my hair. I like to wear my hair like this also because it'll last me a couple of days. Usually after I do my hair like this, I can just wake up in the morning, maybe throw a little extra hairspray in it, run my fingers through it, and maybe touch up the front curls, but usually it's pretty much good to go. The last thing that I like to do, because we did do a lot of teasing and kind of roughed our hair up a little bit, is I like to hit it with a shine spray. This will soften the crunch of the hairspray and just give it a nice shine as well. So that is it for this hair tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed. And if you're someone like me that kind of has this same style of hair and you like to wear it like this, I'm telling you to go out and try this Kendra Dry Thickening Spray. It is seriously thebomb.com. I'm super excited that I found it. It's just like the best thing ever to me. So that is it for this video. I don't think I have anything else to say except I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, I will talk to you guys soon.